Hi everyone, it's Rachel back with another round of science fiction and fantasy reads. As always, I got some good stuff here to share with you. I'm really excited about just about everything I'm here to talk about. Mostly science fiction in this video, but I do have some fantasy at the end, which pretty much represents my taste. I tend to read more science fiction than fantasy, as you know, but I enjoy them both. They definitely scratch different itches at different times. I think I have some good recommendations here, so let's get started. First, I read The Andromeda Strain by Michael Crichton, which is set in a near future where there's an outbreak of some kind of virus or disease that has deadly effects on a community. And so a group of leading scientists are brought in to figure out what has happened, how it is spread, and hopefully find a cure. I've wanted to read more Michael Crichton for quite a while. I love Jurassic Park and have always heard that his thrillers are fantastic for anyone like myself that enjoys a good dose of hard science fiction. I liked this one, but I'll be honest, it took me a while to get into. At times, I found the narrative to be a little bit dry, but the parts of the book that I did enjoy were, of course, the scientists actually figuring out the pathology behind this disease. I really liked learning about the different ways that they test and the different ways that they kind of determine the causes, how it is spread. All of that was incredibly fascinating to me. There was a few survivors of this community that otherwise was wiped out by the virus. And so you have to figure out what these people have in common. And I did like that mystery aspect to it. I'm always a sucker for a mystery. So I'll say that I really liked it in concept, but my attention did wane at times. I just don't think it was quite the page turner I expected it to be, especially from Michael Crichton, but definitely glad I enjoyed it. I decided not to continue on with the second book, which I think is called The Andromeda Evolution. So if you do think that one's worth reading, please let me know. Next, I read a book called We Are Legion, We Are Bob by Dennis E. Taylor. And this is set in a future where a man has become incredibly rich from selling off his tech company. And he decides to use his newfound money to pay to have his brain preserved after his death. So with the idea that if he dies prematurely, they will be able to bring him back in the future in hopefully a new body or something like that. Of course, right after he pays for this, he gets into an accident and he wakes up in the far-flung future and his mind has been placed into an artificial intelligence, kind of like a computer. And this is a very interesting story because it deals a lot with some hard science concepts, but it also deals with a lot of nerdy, geeky references, as I'll get into. I did read this as an audiobook, and I definitely think that's the best way to experience it. I previously tried to read this book via Kindle Unlimited, but I just really struggled to get into it because I honestly don't think the writing is very good. But the story itself is pretty fun, and the narration by Ray Porter really brought the story up a level. And so this is a story about a man who finds himself in this new society, and he basically ends up replicating himself, which is where the title comes from, because he creates not just one Bob, but many Bobs. And so all of these different versions of himself go on to do different tasks throughout the galaxy. And this is where the geeky aspects come into play because they need a way to differentiate between them all so they're not just calling each other Bob. And so this book gets filled with nerdy references. A lot of the Bobs get called things like Goku and Riker, which if you're a Trekkie nerd or an anime nerd, you'll start to recognize where those are coming from. But I definitely enjoyed the humor. I enjoyed all the old references to pop culture and Star Trek and so forth. But it's the kind of story that you just kind of go along with and enjoy. So if you're looking for a science fiction book that is a little bit more lighthearted, this is one to recommend. People do mention that it does have concepts of hard science fiction in it, but it's really written in a way for a layperson. And it's just filled with a lot of humor, very fun, lighthearted again. And I didn't love it, but enjoyed it enough and would recommend it for anyone looking for something that's kind of a bit escapist. Next, we have Sea of Rust by C. Robert Cargill. And this is a story told over two timelines. One is in the future present day where you find out that there was a war between artificial intelligence and the humans that created them, and the AI basically won. And so the story follows an artificial intelligence that is going through this desert called the Sea of Rust that is filled with the dead bodies of robots that have broken down. They are a salvager that is looking for parts in order to repair themselves. And this modern future is basically a story that almost reads like a space western, because there are different groups and there are shootouts and vigilantes, and it's an interesting story for sure. But what I really liked about it was the second timeline, and that is the parts of the story that actually flash back to the past, and it explains where the rise of the artificial intelligence came from, how they started to gain momentum, and what happened that really led to the war between the humans and the robots that they created. And for me, those parts were far more interesting. I never really got attached to the main robot that we're following, but instead I just really enjoyed the parts that had to do with the history. This book definitely does make references to the concepts that Isaac Asimov introduced in iRobot, so if you're interested in those ideas, there's a lot of fascinating discussion in this one about personhood and the challenges or negative effects of giving artificial intelligence human rights. So I definitely recommend this one to anyone who's looking for more of an intellectual story. While I appreciated the action parts of the story, they just didn't hit home for me because the character work was just underdeveloped in my opinion, but still worth reading, it's still enjoyable, and yeah, for me, I'll read any book that involves artificial intelligence. It's definitely one of my bookish buzzwords when it comes to science fiction. And last, I want to talk about Vigilance by Robert Jackson Bennett. This is a sci-fi novella set in a dystopian future in America that is honestly not too far away from the present day. In this future, we follow a man who works as a producer on a reality TV show where humans are basically tasked with killing each other with guns. So people are hired to become the vigilantes, and they go around and shoot up people in malls and other public places. And then you actually have the public that are then shooting back at these killers and trying to gun them down. The concept is all built around the idea that if there are going to be crazy shooters out in the world, if there are going to be mass shootings happening in America, then there is the idea that in order to protect yourselves, in order to be prepared, people must be vigilant. And in this future, that means carrying a gun and knowing how to use it and being accurate. And this story is scary in the way that it feels very plausible. What I didn't totally love about the story was the fact that I did feel that the themes around gun control were very heavy-handed. Don't get me wrong, as a Canadian, I actually share a lot of people's concerns about the gun management in the States, but I still found that the themes were really heavy-handed to the point of like hitting the reader over the head with them, and I typically prefer more subtle storytelling. So I'd rather it be toned down and just kind of nudged at, but this was like very over the top. It's very clear how the author feels about gun control in America. So I would recommend this one to, of course, those of you that share the author's beliefs. If you feel differently about gun control, you'll probably really hate this book. And keep in mind again that it's not exactly subtle, but it is an interesting story. It's very fast paced with some really good commentary on what's going on. And I will say that the ending was really solid. I would recommend this one to fans of Black Mirror because it definitely has that dystopian feel that I enjoy so much in some of my science fiction. Finally, I want to talk about some fantasy, and I read Jade City and Jade War, both by Fonda Lee, and this is a really unique fantasy book that is not like pretty much anything else I typically read, and I think that's why I liked it so much. It's technically a piece of urban fantasy, which is normally not my thing, but while this is urban fantasy, I want to clarify that it's not a romance, which so many urban fantasies are. Instead, this is set in a modern day and follows these Asian societies that get superpowers from having jade on their bodies. And the story basically follows different crime families that are fighting against each other for territory and power in this state. And I just found it to be very fascinating. It's very action-packed. There's a lot of focus on martial arts, which is super cool. And while it is fantasy, it's definitely toned down. Obviously, people get their abilities enhanced by jade, but they still have to train really hard. They still have to go to school and learn martial arts in order to be effective. And what I love so much about the series was definitely the character work. There were really strong female characters as well as male characters that were all very unique and different from each other. They made mistakes and were just real people and just very relatable, very interesting. I'm not always someone who gets super attached to characters in books, but this is probably some of the best character work that I have personally read in fantasy. So definitely recommend recommend this series to anyone who's looking for a diverse story that is just really different than a lot of the other fantasy books that are out there. I was getting a little bit burnt out on some of the really classic fantasy books that I'd read in the past, and this one just hit the mark for me and was just so refreshing. Highly recommend it, and I definitely plan on reading the next book whenever it comes out. So that is it for this video. I would love to hear your comments down below of the books I mentioned here. Which ones are you most interested in reading? And share with me a fantasy book or series that you feel is really different and just breaks down a lot of the tropes that you normally see in a lot of those classic fantasy stories. I'm always looking for something different, and I love your recommendations. If you haven't yet subscribed, please do so. I do read a lot of science fiction, some fantasy, and of course, thrillers and horror books. And if you are subscribed, thank you so much. Please give this video a thumbs up, hit that notification bell, and I will talk to you again soon. Thanks, okay, bye-bye.